Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to test or validate your Power BI report or Power BI data with your source data. This is most requested video, or most of them asked in the comments. That is why I thought of making a one video for it. How I will validate, or usually people can validate the Power BI report. There is no automated way to validate your report. It has to be done manually. That is what I'm going to walk you through in this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So basically, this is what called as manual testing. And whatever application you develop, people do the manual testing. Similar way, Power BI, once you develop the report, people has to do the manual testing to validate your report. So what kind of validations you can make? Check the count, meaning like number of rows in your source matching with the number of rows that you have imported in Power BI. That is your first thing you need to do. Then check the sum and aggregation. Sometimes count matches, but due to some aggregation, you have kept some nullable columns or 0 or 1. Based on that, something may go wrong. So you need to check the respective column aggregation, right? I mean to say, like, once you check the count of rows is matching, don't leave it, everything is loaded. You have to use the particular measure and check it in the both source and the Power BI reports. Know the logics in entire flow or pipeline. You may aware, like in most of my videos, I have repeatedly talking about Power BI alone is not enough, because Power BI is part of the business intelligence ecosystem. There will be a staging or data warehouse in place or reporting environment. So wherever you are using that Power BI, right, underlying you can have a data warehouse or some other staging database for reporting, whatever it can be. So you need to check from the source and then staging or data warehouse, then also in my next slide. And one last thing is, like, you need to validate the calculations. So that is what I'm going to show as a demo. And how you can do is, like, start with simple calculation. You, as I said before, count or sum or whatever calculations. Calculations basically involves your measures, whatever you created, like YTD, MTD, or you use some complex DAX calculations using tree test or some other calculations, right? So everything you need to validate completely in order to ensure it's working fine or not. So to start with, you start with simple calculations. Then if a particular calculation involves multiple measures, right, dependent measures, you have one calculation you have written initially and the same measure you have used in another measure. So start with first level of calculation. You need to validate that one, it's working fine. Then you go for the dependent calculations. This is how a flow should be. So what I'm trying to explain about the multiple stages in here is, like, so the Power BI alone cannot survive. I mean, people are not able to work only on Power BI. They need to get the source, right? People now, Microsoft claim you can skip the entire data warehouse architecture, directly get it from data source, all those things, right? So either if you are following this one, write your queries on your source, or whatever you are trying to get, you write your queries, then same thing you need to validate in the Power BI. Or if you are using the data warehouse typical architecture following here, you can write at each stage from here to here. Once you have picked up how many rows it is validated, I mean, 1,000 rows you are picking up from source, 1,000 rows are loaded or not, that validation you need to make. Then from here to data warehouse, you need to make another check. From data warehouse to tabular, if it is exist, then tabular to Power BI. When whatever may the flow, each stage you need to ensure the data is properly populated, right? So the only quick check you can do is count of rows, and then you can do the validation of your measures and other calculations as well. This is what in short and how you can validate your Power BI report using some demo I will demonstrate now. So we are in Power BI now, and you have a simple model here that is from AdventureWorks database, fact internet sales, dim sales territory, dim customer, and dim date, three dimensions. So first thing we need to validate is the count. So you can write these measures for validation. You can create some other table for testing and hide it for end user perspective. And this video is essentially meant for testing. So I don't have any other visuals here, just how you can validate your Power BI reports. That's what I want to make. So just I created this measure. So just use this one, that is count. And I can use the table label so that it will appear properly, and none. So there are 564542 rows. Then you can use the aggregation sales amount. You can either create it or drag and drop here so that you can view it properly. So 2787756, this is the value. This is the first check you need to make. So where I need to validate? It should be validated immediately in the source where this Power BI is picking up the data. So how you can verify? You can go to transform data, you know where it is picking up from. You can check it from advanced editor. It is picking up from this database, and this is the table or view name. So I'm using the AdventureWorks database. I going to SSMS, and I have this data here. First thing you need to do is the count of rows. Check this one, and as soon as you query it in the database, you can check how many rows it contains. Let's see it in this once it returns the results. So that is the validation you need to make. So here it is 56555, whereas in Power BI it is 56542. Okay, there is a conflict here. So this is how you can understand how the conflict occurs. So data won't be accurate. So where you need to check now? First of all, you need to understand this is the pointer of Power BI. So there is no issues in this layer. Meaning like when I go to this diagram, you see here, I'm not having this SSA layer. I'm reading it from data varos. So this view count is 555 in the database, but in Power BI I'm getting 542. So basically what happened here, in between data varos to Power BI there is a count mismatch. So you need to aware, you have done some transformations in your Power Query editor or somewhere while reading it, right? So how you can ensure it? Go and check it here. I know I have filtered, that is why I am seeing here. You can check these steps. So what it has done? So you are ignoring the 2010 data. Okay, the data contains 2010 three dates. You are ignoring it. Okay, so that is what you are doing it. No, you see here number filter. I have ignored these three dates. So this also you need to verify it here. You need to put it here in your test cases. So this is order date key is greater than equal to 2011-0101. Now you have to query it. So this should be saved somewhere to document it. This is what you have verified, and take a screenshot. Once you run this query, then you see like 56542 is appearing now, and then it is the same count. So what I'm trying to explain it here is like you need to understand the entire flow, meaning like whatever changes you did anywhere in the flow, like the complete flow, you need to aware and apply the same filters in your source where you are verifying. You are verifying here, but there is transformation or some logics you applied in between. That transformation or logics to be applied in your source to validate it. Now your first check is done, which giving you the correct count. Excuse me. So similarly you can do the sum of measures. So in the same query I can use the sum of sales amount. I have a measure already over here. I can reuse it. Sales. Okay, you can write it over here. Meanwhile, so you see here 2787756. It is same. 2787756. Okay, this is how you can quickly verify. So in case of database, you need to know the SQL. So this is why I'm saying Power BI alone is not enough. You need to learn multiple skills if you are want to verify your data, how you can verify without knowing SQL queries. So that is the reason I'm saying you need to learn multiple technologies. One last set test case how I can verify here is like I've written YTD. How we can verify the YTD figure? So let us take this one, and I will have a full alternate date key. I don't want quarter and year. I mean date. I will have year and month. Then we will use the YTD measure over here. I have created, this is the YTD formula. You can see it is simple. Sum of YTD sales, dim date dot full date, alternate key, dim date. So I will use that one and we will try to verify it. So how you can verify it? Again, you need to use the SQL queries to verify it, right? So let us try to put this data over here. Now let me increase the size slightly so that you can view the values properly. I hope it is clear now. Now you can see from 2011 January, February, March, April, October till December. Okay, this is the sales amount, individual month amount, and this is the YTD value. Okay, whether this value is correct or not, how we can verify it? So now you can go and check. This is the formula. There is no formula written for YTD here. What I did is I have taken order date key left of 6, meaning like let's try to query some data from the fact table here. Select top 10 star from, okay, star, it is star. There is 2 from here. Now you can see here it includes the date. Okay, I don't want the date. So what I put is like just sum of I will remove these two characters, last two characters. So that's why I put left of 6. That will become my month number, and I use the count and sum of sales. Okay, once I query this, what I will get over here is like for each month, okay, ignore the 10th, that is not our case. So this month, okay, this particular year, the YTD is appearing correct or not for 2011. That's what we want to check. So for 2011-01, the sales amount is 441571, and we'll go to Power BI. 2011 January, the figure is 471. It is not correct. It is because I'll tell you. See, this is how you need to check why it is not correct. Because now you are using this. I made it purposefully. I assume this query is using the order date key, but what date Power BI is using, that we need to ensure. Okay, we have used YTD, dim date dot date. Okay, dim date dot date, full date, alternate key, sum up. But what is the relationship between the date and fact? So here you can see the difference. It is date key and due date key. That is why it is not matching. So we need to enable the proper relation, active relationship for the order date key. Once I imported order due date key was default active relationship, that's why it became like that. Now I will make the order date key active here. So these are the some of the test cases once you query it and try to troubleshoot the between the different dates. Now you can see for January 2011 441579. So 441579, this is correct. And for February 454201, 454201, this also correct. Now, whether these two are correct or not, I mean YTD is nothing but these sum of these two appears here, right? How I can verify? So take this entire data and put it in a sheet, okay? Now you sum of these two, it is, let me zoom out. Yes, you can see here 895781, and go to Power BI 895789. Okay, if you sum up the entire year here, okay, the entire 2011, it is 677181. Now you go to 2011 December 677181. So this is how you can verify. It is only a manual testing. You need to ensure the count of rows appear properly, then you can drag and drop your calculations. If it is not good, whether the mistake can be in relationship or the calculations, or you need to verify one by one. Okay, where when it, the issue happens, you need to figure it out where the issue can happen, what may be the reasons. Okay, this is how you can verify it. There is no quick fix to verify it. There is no tool to verify it right now. We are, no one is using. If anyone knows that such a tool, please let us know in the comments. And this is for SQL background. Those were if your source is SQL, you can verify it in the way I'm doing. You can write different queries, either it can be a YTD or MTD. Even if you can able to write a YTD query here, right, using a windowing function, we can able to write, but I'm not, don't want to waste my time. If you're very good in SQL, you can write similar query what output appears in the Power BI, then you can verify it if it is a SQL. If you can ask me, what about in case of Excel? In Excel, always it is nothing but your Power BI is nothing but your pivoting table, or you can say like a compressed model, right? So you do the pivoting. So in Excel case, you do the pivoting. First, you can quickly verify using count. You cannot write queries here. Instead, you can choose this one and you can verify number of count. Count is 46707. So I'm not using this Excel in Power BI. I'm saying how you can verify in it case of Excel. So just click on that column, you check the count, this is your count, but ensure that column you are choosed is not having a null values. Excel will ignore if you have a null count over there. Okay, so and then you use the sum, right? You, for selling price, you can use the sum whether it's verified correct or not. So this is simple way to verify. And if you want, you can have a pivot table also. You can insert a pivot table and then you have a similar feature like a matrix table, you can verify using that. So like over here, simple calculations like this, okay, just you can put some columns here, count of location, you can verify the same figure is appearing in Power BI or not. So this is how usually people will verify. Almost 90% maybe some people have a different approach. If you know, just let us know and I will demonstrate in a separate video. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.